Saints, brothers and sisters, prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries and first qualify our sins. I confess,
Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I've done and what I've failed to do. Through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask that the Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to whom our brothers and sisters pray for me, pray on me, O Lord our God.
And my God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
And then actually, I know it's time my brother in Michigan, and things seem to be going well. And you got to see Bishop Pelosi. That was a surprise thing, but it would happen. We got to see each other for about 5 minutes, and that was very fun. And he's doing really well, and they're really happy to have him there. So, today we have three meetings, and the one about the Ark, I was just curious about this. The word Ark, you were talking about the, it's used, you know, Noah's Ark, and I guess it's the Ark of Covenant. And I spent so many years there with thought about the different, what that means. I looked up the word a little bit, and it has different meanings for, in at least the regular dictionary, has different meanings for the Ark, Noah's Ark, and the Ark of Covenant, because they said the Ark stuff is boat, you know? And then they also said the Ark is that holds the, you know, the sacred weapon, it holds the sacred tablets. But the thing I thought about is they both journey, you know, not journey, you know, the safety and protection. Noah's Ark, you know, guided them through the waters and kept them safe until, you know, until it was safe. Now, this part of the covenant, I guess, does the same thing. And they guided them as they were, when they were going through the desert. And as we heard, it stopped and started. You know, God said, go, go. God said, stay here. They stayed there. And, you know, protecting and guiding them, but eventually into right the promised land. And so we pray for us our own life that we have God guiding us on that too. We've got our own tabernacle that we sit in front of and gaze, and I know God's dwelling is there. We have our own life, we have our own circumstances. Please guide us, Lord, with our family, please guide us with our own personal lives, please guide us with the people we love and where we're going, with our illnesses and with jobs and our tasks and our duties, and we know that like the Ark, you're there with us. Give us the faith and grace, and may this Eucharist fill us with His presence guiding us. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. For the church, may she continue to lead the body of Christ as Jesus desires. Through His love and care, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all nations and peoples of the world, may the Lord's call for justice and for peace over war guide them in all that they do. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have difficulty finding meaningful and steady employment, may God strengthen and uphold them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this Eucharistic assembly, may God's grace help us to keep the Eucharist at the center of our lives in prayer. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Pat Costanzo and all the faithful departed, may they be reunited in glory with Christ our Savior. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our local economy, especially for jobs, for progress and for a stable future, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in the Ukraine, the United States, and the world, and for any special attentions you wish to offer. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For God to help us every step of the way of our lives, thank you.
Amen. Blessed be God forever. Blessed be God forever. May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit, we lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right
into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity, according to your will, you who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of our Lord Jesus be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
We share a sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. You said. your Spirit.
God's blessings upon you, in the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Your peace.
Thanks be to God. Thank you, Father Paul, you too. Father Paul, we'd like to wish you a very happy birthday.
Yes.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.